Ladies and gentlemen, and all the rest of you barbarians out there, hello and welcome to Conan Exiles, open world game set in the Conan mythos. Game dropped a couple of days ago, 2 days ago? 2 days ago for me. And looked forward, wanted to play this game since I realized it was coming out. I think this is going to be a good game that's going to scratch that Ark itch without having to get back into Ark, although I may do that eventually. So yeah, I kind of want to keep up with this game and its updates and see how it fares against the titans, that is, games like Ark and Rust and a few others. So, could you call them titans? I don't know. I'll call them titans. So I'm going to get in here, I'm going to create a character, and I'm not going to make you sit through that. And when you see me again, we're going to be on the other side in the desert. See you there. I ain't gonna make you sit through this, because chances are you've already read it all. I've read it at least twice. So let's get on past this. And here we are. We are in the exiled lands. And right over here,
I am beaten. Left to rot among the ruins of the past. There are others here. Slaves. Bandits and cannibals. Exiles from lands I've never heard of. Some of them try to scrape a life from the wasteland, scrabbling in the rocks and sand for their own place. I cannot go on.
Okay, I just checked my recording. I hope that didn't kill the sound on the guy talking there. I think it might have. But, yeah. So, basically, you might be able to see it from here. That little emblem thing on my hand right there, that bracelet. If you ever try to take it off, it kills you. If you try to walk beyond the lands that it constricts you to, it kills you. He walked beyond those lands. He got tired of being here. We're going to conquer these lands.
Behold, bonded one. The very boundaries of civilization. Beyond the passage of our highways lie the wild places of the world, where untamed savages make endless war upon each other. You cannot pass into the endless wastes enslaved. Your bonding prevents it. Return. Follow the road. Any road. All roads.
So I guess we're going to the city. I'm going to gather up some, you'll see what that is in a minute, if you hadn't already. But I'm going to gather up some plant fibers and some bugs to eat along the way. Also need to apply some pointage, which I just got. And we're going to go with survivability and encumbrance. Go ahead and learn that so we can get a hatchet, bedroll, and some goodies there. Water down here. Just a sip left. That's about all we need. Let's move on and see what that sound was, huh? Probably shouldn't be running in a desert. That kind of depletes your water a little more. Some more plant fibers. Try to make that bedroll as soon as we can because we don't want to respawn out here. Don't worry, I'm getting to you. Hush up. Try to get some of these plant fibers so I can make a bedroll so I don't have to respawn way out here when I die, because I will. I think I've got my computer settings to, like, our computer settings, the video settings to, like, medium, and it's running relatively smooth. I hope it runs smooth via the recording. And right now you should be able to see something up in the distance doing some weird stuff. Let's go creep up on it and see what it's doing. Oop, you're in a branch. Yeah, you fly off, little critter. What's up, y'all? Dude had his leg chawed off.
Gods, curse this sandstorm.
We were forced to take refuge before the wind scoured the skin from our faces. There is something in the storm. Beasts. We hear the skittering of their paws outside the ruins, and their howls mingled with the screaming winds. The men are scared. I've put them to work crafting rudimentary weapons and torches from the loose stones and rough plants that dot this place. I've yet to meet a beast that liked fire, or the bite of the axe.
Now, I did decide to turn up the XP gain and a few other options, because I'm playing this on here solo. And I found out very quickly while playing with D-Swank, Elephant Crunch, and a few others that this game does not favor the solo play. And I will be joining them again. I had some footage. I thought I had some footage playing with them. And I realized that I'm not timing how much I am recording here. We don't want this to be too long, do we? And, I did not like the settings I had through OBS, and it recorded nothing but my background. My desktop. And, so I had to set the game to windowed mode. And we're doing good so far. So anyway, coming over to Breach, and we have a little bit of greenery up there. A little less harsh looking land. Let's go ahead and see if we can make us a bedroll. What do we need for that? Need some twine. We can make twine. We need three. Three twine. Let those make. Now we gotta be careful because I know there's some imps around. And the imps are not a play. Yeah, there's one right yonder. What can we do right here? Let's go ahead and get us something to protect ourselves with. Craft that. Do I have enough fibers for these? I got 53. I can make that one. I might be able to make a couple of these. Did I run out of fiber? I guess my crafting queue is too high. Let me get this stuff made and something to smack that imp with, and I'll bring you back. Alright, looks like I need some more stuff, and it looks like I might have tweaked the crafting speed by accident, because it is taking forever to craft some clothes. And I need some stones. I need some stones, I need some more plant fiber to make twine before I can make something to smack that imp with. I do have a pick, though. So let's move on up. He's probably going to see me come running at me. You can see him right there hiding. He's still running up with his bare naked ass and Willy hanging out there. So let's, yep, here he comes. Come on, ugly. Yeah. You got some hellified reach on you. Ugly. Alright. You got anything on you? No. Take some flesh, though. Yeah. Flesh and hide. That's what we need. Alright, so let's gather up some stones. I'm going to gather up some more plant fiber. I'm going to get some clothes made and a sword. And I will meet you on the other side. We might explore a bit before we set down our bedroll. Alrighty. We've made us a sword. And in making stuff, also gained a few more points. I see a few more points. Another level. And I have learned the Apprentice Stonemason. Stonemason. Which allows me to make all these goodies here. Now, let's go out here and explore a wee little bit and see if we can find us a place to call home. We need to get this water bag filled up pretty quick. We also need to find us a source of food pretty soon, too. Which means killing more imps and deer and something that's not going to fight back as hard as those shellbacks. The big turtle man things there. Once you get too close to them, get rather aggressive. So let's go over here to the water and see about getting us a full but hello, but oh crap, there's two of them. Hello. Ouch. Get out of my face with your wiggling dinglings. Bare asses. Give me your flesh. Hey buddy. Join your friends. Alright. There you go. I hope you're happy now. Give me your flesh. I need food. Give me your flesh. And I think I might have tweaked the tool degradation, the tool damage a little much as well. So I'm gonna have to go back and check that too. Fresh water. Let's get us some. And fill up our bag. And let's see, can we make a campfire yet? Ooh, do I have a level? I do. Let's go with survivability. And we'll do experienced survivalist. That'll give us the the water bag in case I get killed and lose it. And a campfire so we can start cooking. What do we need for a campfire? 50 stone, 50 branches, 30 stone. Alright. Well, we know what we need to do. That's something I like about it. If you look down on the right, it keeps track of how many stone you actually have on you, which is pretty cool. So there's that. Now we need some branches. And I think there's a bunch of branches out this way. At least I thought there was. Yeah, there's some branches. We're gonna need how many branches? 30? Ow! Ow! I think I just pissed off a shellback. I did. Mm-hmm. Crap! Run! Pick up the branches as you run! They stay aggroed? He is still aggroed. Oh no! I just got started, leave me alone. Oh crap, there's people over there. The NPCs are all hostile, and I think they just saw me. They did. Shit. I'm about to die. Yep, here he comes. All glitched out. Here he comes. Okay, buddy. Me and you. We'll go. We'll go. Die, huh? Chopped your ass. Where? Really? Are you still aggroed on me? Please tell me you're not aggroed. You're aggroed on me. God dang it. What the? What kind of glitch is that? Look at that. It's like I'm carrying both my axe and my pick. My sword and my pick, and I'm stalled. Shit, two of them on me, and an imp. I'm gonna die. I got them all pissed off at me. I'm about to run out of stamina, and they're still chasing me. The imp is, and the shellbacks are too. God dang it. And I'm out of stamina. Okay, I think the shellback quit chasing me. Mm. Come on, then. I can take you two. I can take you two. Uh-huh. I can take both of you. Hey, we're about to get a little asses. Alright. I'm out of stamina. Give me your hide and flesh. Sword back. And that's another thing. Much like in Ark, where you could kind of repair, well, I can't repair, you can make things from your quick bar down there, you can repair things from your quick bar here. And something else I learned while playing in the multiplayer with D-Swank and them, if you don't have enough materials to fully fix something, you can partially fix it. And that's handy. That's actually quite nice. And we got some shellbacks over there. And I'm starving. I don't have anything to eat. Do I have anything to eat? I got bugs. That'll hold me for a little bit. I'm about to die of starvation. Okay. Quickly, quickly, quickly. Can we make a campfire? What am I short? I'm short. Oh God, I'm short stone and the branches. Okay. Oop, there's a nice big grub. That'll give me something to eat. I don't don't want to eat the raw stuff because that'll make me sick. Put a little belly, a little food in my belly. Now, this first episode, maybe even the second episode, I'm going to try to keep you with me as I'm going, just because, you know, a bunch of new features to talk about and whatnot, and different things that we're going to see along the way. But later on, I will probably keep this a heavily edited series, much like my Space Engineer series was before multiplayer. Right, that's enough stone. I need branches. I think I can get branches from you. Maybe, I'm stuck. Wouldn't work. No, we don't do that. Alright, I think there's some eggs over here. Yes, give me them eggs. Excuse me while I steal your little brothers and sisters. I'm hungry. Move! Okay, can we stop here for a second? I think so. Where are the eggs at? Go ahead and swallow these eggs down. Oh yeah, that's much better. Much, much better. Alright. Another grub, we can eat that. Alright, that should hold us for a little while. Now we can find some branches so we can start cooking some food. So I guess, unless I get jumped, oh no, that's not good. That's a crocodile over there. Let's not go that way. I'm going to try to find me some branches and get us a fire pit made, and I guess I'll bring you back when I get that done. There's some more branches. Oh, hello! What are you doing? Why are you raising your hands up? I'm trying to kill you, and you're an idiot. And there's another one over there. Oop, and got another one. Go on now. And I just broke my sword. You got anything on you? Yeah, you got plant fiber. Okay. Well, pretty good. I just kind of knocked all them out. Took them down. Nice big campfire, which I can't do anything with. I wish you could use the campfires that you find. Like, yeah, if you... Uh-oh. Oh, crap! Crocodile! God dang it! Crocodile, crocodile, crocodile. Still ain't got enough branches yet. Another crocodile. I wish it wouldn't do that. Crocodile coming. I think it lost its aggro. Okay. Good. Come here, rabbit. Alright. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and place down my spawn point right about here, I think. Would be decent enough. Spawn point updated. Good. I don't know if these are single-use or multi-use. I'm going to guess and assume that they're single-use because of how cheap they are to make. So, yeah, we still need how many more branches? 10 more branches, and we can make us a fire pit. So, let's go find some branches. Alright, there's 50 branches. And just in time, because we're about to starve again, let's go ahead and place down us a... Where's it at? Right there. Craft. That's going to take a minute. Went ahead and leveled up again, and I learned the wooden box so we can store some stuff, so we can make us some more twine. Can we make enough twine? Not quite, so we need some more plant fibers. What is that? I just heard something. It sounded quite nasty, too. Okay. So, again, we're about to start. Let's put this down. Where Where's that ant? Right there's on there. And boom. There we go. Now let's put some wood in there. And all of that meat's done. Done spoiled on me. So we can drop that. Can't use that. Leather journal. Don't care to use any of that. It's just taking up place. Put the feral flesh in there. And a lot of this is going to get dropped. The bones I need to keep, though. Alright, so 13 fibers. How many more can I make? Fibers. Twine. How many more twine can I make? I can make one more. That gives me 14. And I need 15 for this. No, only 14. Craft the box. Alrighty. Well, I have some place to store some stuff. Eat and respawn. And we might go and try to build us a tiny little shelter before the first sandstorm comes in. Because we don't want to be outside during sandstorms. No sure bob. Alright, so let's put the seeds away. I'll go and eat those. Now. Okay. We'll put the hide away. Can't use that. Put the bark, the bone. And we'll keep those on us. I'll see if we can keep this one. So we're going to drop them. Drop it like it's hot. Not going to use any of that. Or that. Or that. There we go. We need a... Alright. So how much did it actually repair? So a little bit. See how a little bit it repaired? So that's nice that you can... And I am starving! We got some... Yep, shredded roast. Here we go. Eat that shredded roost. Okay, that was good. That's a lot of health we just got back. I mean, not health, hunger. Okay. So, I'm gonna go ahead and go gather up some stone. Some... What do we need for these? What do we need? We need stone and wood. We got a lot of wood. And we just used a majority of it. So, we need wood and stone. We can get that. So I'm going to gather up some wood and stone. I'm going to make up some foundations. I'm going to make some walls, some ceilings, and some other good stuff. And I'll bring you back for our little shelter. Alrighty. We are back. Where's my timer? Go timer. Yeah, there we go. We are back, and I've depleted all of my local resources here without straying too far from my spawn point. And night is coming. But we have everything we need to get a small 4x4 beginning shelter did. So let's quickly get this thing down so we can call this a night. Because it gets dark. It gets really, really dark. Now, fun thing, the way we can place stuff here, unlike Ark, which is a bit of a pain to build with sometimes, if you run into this weird location, I think it is a shift. Yes! Shift and scroll wheel will raise your, what you call it here, your foundation, and that is such a glorious, glorious thing. Whoop! What? They need to get rid of that noise. It's a glorious, glorious thing. Also, scroll wheel by itself will turn it round and round it goes. So, I think I do want to be off the ground a little bit. Actually, I don't because I don't have stairs yet. So let's drop that down. And there's our platform. Little 4x4 platform. And I might have to very quickly build me a torch. Because it's about to get dark. Can I make a torch? I need some more plant fibers. I have them in here. I don't. Let me get me a couple of plant fibers. Get us a torch going because it's getting dark on us. I think that's all I needed. Can I get some plant farmers here? No. Can we make it now? No, I still need 10 plant fibers. Crap! It's dark, man! It is super freaking dark. And there's lights over there. So we know there's some NPCs out that way. So, I'm gonna try to find me some more plant fibers. Come on, give me... Nope. That's stone. There we go, plant fibers. Crap! That's a hyena. Whoa. I can't see what... Oh, okay, it's dead. I think it's dead. I hear something stomping around. I don't know what it is. It's probably about to kill me. Okay. Oh. Wait, what? I got the plant fiber. I've only got two plant... Where'd my plant fiber go? Oh, I made one. Here it is. Oof. There we go. I hear them hyenas. Let's get away from them. Alright, here we go. Let's put some wood in here so we can get our campfire back going, because that will give us some light as well. Oh! That it is. Yep, that's what I thought. Come on, ugly. Oh, crap, I just ran out. Oh, no, I'm gonna die. I'm gonna die. Give me your shit, man. That was just unnecessary. Okay, let's throw that on the fire. Get us more meat going. Oof, okay. So, yeah, that's fun. Let's build some walls. Here's another beautiful thing. It even tells you the outer face is facing out. Look at that. I love it. I'm gonna put my door there, I think. Alright, let's get my door. That, and my ceiling. Oh, I had them. Alright, let's put these down here. We need the door. Put that there. The ceilings. We'll put right there, and the door we'll leave in there for the time being. Come in here. Oops, we need that back. There's that. Our ceilings. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And looks like we're just in time, because it looks like a sandstorm's a brewing. Sure sounds like it. And there is our door. And now we have a safe place to call home, get out of sandstorms, and call this an episode as morning does come. Thankfully, the nights aren't long. So we survived our first night without dying after being attacked by hyenas in the night, turtle men in the night, and, yeah, being chased by crocodiles and imps and everything else. So I hope you all did enjoy this episode. I hope you all enjoy this series as it rolls along, as I get the opportunity to record it. I definitely think I'm going to enjoy this. I hope I'm going to enjoy this. I'm enjoying it now. I enjoy it multiplayer. So, until we see you all in the next episode, I do hope you all have a wonderful evening. And, yeah, I keep doing that kind of backwards. Anyway, good night, everybody.